everyone. How's it going? It's Liz from the Definity Foundation, and welcome to Community Conversations. So this is an opportunity for you, the community, to hear from contributors within the internet computer ecosystem, as well as get the opportunity to ask some questions live. So similarly to how the SNS is the open tokenized governance system that controls the internet computer blockchain, service nervous systems, or SNSs, are algorithmic DAOs that will allow developers to create decentralized token-based governance systems for their dapps. In this talk, we will propose a design for how SNSs, consisting of a governance canister, a ledger canister, and a root canister, can be deployed and upgraded. This talk will be given by researcher Lara Schmidt and software engineer Nicholas Zoe. Lara, feel free to take it away.
Thank you very much, Liz. So I'll mainly give the talk, but Nico will also be around then for the question part. And also welcome from my side to this talk on our proposal for the design on how to deploy and upgrade SNSs. So, let me very briefly recap what a service nervous system is and what's the motivation for them, but I'll try to keep this part very short because I think we already covered that in other talks and articles. So yeah, but just to make sure that everyone is on the same page. So the network nervous system, or also called the SNS, is the open governance system that governs the full internet computer with all its subnets and nodes. And the service nervous system is a very similar concept. It's also an open governance system, but rather than the internet computer, an SNS just governs one decentralized application, or also called dapp. So that means in particular that we would have one service nervous system for one dApp. Now, why would we want to have such an SNS? So a few key concepts that are needed for true Web3 applications are that dApps are truly hosted on chain. And by that, I mean end to end, including the front end and everything. And also they should be user owned and user controlled. And for the last two points, we actually need a DAO, or a decentralized autonomous organization. And that's exactly what an SNS is. So an SNS enables two key things. First, it enables decentralization. So that means the decentral control over a dApp, how it should be evolved and so forth. So this is the controlled part. The users can control where the dApp goes. And the second thing an SNS enables is tokenization. So it introduces a token which enables ownership of the users over this system. And thereby it also allows for a variety of new incentive systems. So basically this is very shortly in a nutshell why we might want to have SNSs. And let me now, before I dive into the topic of deployment and upgrades, give you a little bit of context around what conversation has already happened with the community, and also what thoughts we already have had on the service nervous system. So last fall, we presented the first design for the service nervous systems. This was a rather complex design, including many canisters, and also with feedback from the community, we then noticed that it's probably better to release in smaller stages and also to aim for making the intermediate steps and the individual canisters available to the community as soon as they are ready. This is then what we also included in our basically high-level proposal that was published in this long-term R&D motion proposal that was then adopted in December. Since then, we have basically started working on the individual canisters, and the canister that actually requires most work is the governance canister, because we want to simplify it compared to the governance canister we have in the SNS. So for this governance canister in particular, we also made a motion proposal to present the new design that was adopted, I think, a few weeks or even days back. So the question is now, if we have these individual canisters that make up an SNS, how can one actually deploy those canisters and upgrade them? And this is what's the topic of today. So before going into the details of the deployment and upgrade, let's look at what canisters we actually propose to have in a first version of the SNS. So we propose to have three canisters: the governance, the ledger, and the root. And basically, where do they come from? So as I already mentioned, the governance canister is what we proposed in a separate motion proposal that was adopted. So this work is now ongoing to implement that. And we propose that the ledger and root, for the ledger and root, we basically take very similar canisters that we already have in the NNS with just some small adoptions that are needed. So let's now recap a little bit what actually these canisters do or what's their purpose. So the governance canister hosts two things. First, it hosts proposals which facilitate decision making on the SNS. So basically, proposals are just suggestions how, for example, the dApp should be evolved. And it also hosts neurons, which determines who are the participants of governance. So everyone can take some tokens and stake them in a neuron. So a neuron contains stake tokens, and then become a participant of this governance system. So it is really an open governance system. And then the ledger canister basically tracks two things. First, it specifies which account has how many tokens, and then it also tracks the transactions between those accounts. And maybe a thing to point out here, the vision would be that each SNS can have its own governance token. So this leaves us with the root. My guess is that maybe some of you have heard of governance and ledger, but root is maybe less popular. So maybe let's look at why do we need the root canister even. So for this, we have to understand how upgrades of canisters work. And an upgrade entails three things. First, one stops a canister, then one installs the new code for this canister, and then one can restart the canister. Now, the problem is that a canister cannot do that and upgrade itself. So for example, the governance canister cannot stop and restart itself. And therefore, we need another canister to orchestrate this upgrade. And this is exactly what the root does. We could have maybe also thought about putting this logic into the ledger and let the ledger upgrade root, but we found that the ledger should be kind of kept as simple as possible, and it's a cleaner solution to have this in a separate canister. And this is actually also what we do on the NNS. We also have a very similar root canister there. And as already mentioned, we actually plan to kind of reuse the code that we already have from the NNS. So once we know what canisters we have, basically the question is where would the actual code of these canisters live? And we propose that this would be in the IC repo, so where the NNS canisters and the rest of the open source code is. And this means that everyone could basically take this code, build it into a canister, and then deploy these canisters on an application subnet. Now, this comes with some challenges. It might be, so this repo is always evolving, right? So there will be different versions of these canisters. And it might be that not all of these versions from the different canisters are actually compatible with each other. So an extreme example, and probably this is not something that we want to do because we want to be backwards compatible, but in an extreme case, you can imagine if we, for example, delete an API method in the governance, it could be that all of a sudden a ledger who wants to call this API is not compatible with this governance anymore. So as I said, that's probably not something we plan to do, but just as an illustration of why versions can become incompatible. And the other problem is that it might not be possible, or that it might not be well defined what happens if we upgrade from any version, for example, of governance to any newer version of governance. So it might, for example, be that if we upgrade from a very old version of governance to a very new version of governance, that somewhere in the middle, we should have done some cleanup that then gets lost, and that this is therefore not secure to do. So because this is very challenging, and each SNS basically has to make sure that all the upgrades are secure, we propose that we could put this information in the NNS registry. So basically the idea here would be that the NNS community could test some things really well, and then they can basically bless this information and put it in the registry. And the SNS communities then know that, okay, certain things have been well tested, and we can already have some confidence that probably if we follow these upgrades, that the outcome will be good. So basically, there are two main informations that we want to have in this registry. As you can see, we actually propose blessing deployment paths. So this includes two things, the single deployments. You can see, for example, the first line would say that the governance, ledger, and root all at version zero are compatible with each other. So this is a deployment that you can kind of deploy these three canisters together. And also the ledger canister version one is compatible with governance and root at version zero. So this is the first information that is in there. The additional information is from which deployment you can upgrade to which new deployment. So here it says that it's this information state that it's fine and it has been well tested, that you can upgrade from this version where all canisters run version zero to the version where the ledger runs version one. So this is basically the idea. And as a small detail, this will be relevant in a few minutes. Actually, these deployment paths do not include the WASM canisters themselves, because that would just be too much information. It rather just refers to WASM modules by specifying the hash of the WASMs. So maybe just to make or to motivate why we suggest blessed deployment paths, let's look at two options, what we could also bless, and see why this might not be a super good idea. So first, rather than blessing upgrade paths, we could just bless WASM versions. So we could, for example, say the following are governance versions that have been well tested and we think they work fine. What could then happen is that, as we already stated, it might be possible that it's fine to upgrade from version zero to version one and from version one to version two, but that it's actually not advisable to upgrade from version zero to version two, because that might break something. Now, if we only had the information that you see on top in the registry, namely just the versions that are blessed, it could of course happen that someone is currently at version zero and sees that version two is blessed and tries to upgrade to it, and then basically chooses this, upgrade path that is actually not advisable. Another alternative could be to just bless the upgrade paths of the individual canisters. So we could say for governance, it's fine to upgrade from version zero to version one. From ledger, it's fine to also upgrade from version zero to version one. Now here, the problem could be about the compatibility that we talked about. So assume, for example, as explained here on the left, that ledger version zero works well with both governance version zero and version one, but ledger version one only works with the ledger, with the governance version one. So basically that would mean that we should first upgrade governance and then ledger. However, again, if we just have the information on top and just know the individual canisters upgrade paths, it could be that someone chooses to first upgrade the ledger and then ends up in this situation where we have two incompatible canisters. And I think these are basically the two main motivations why we propose to have the whole deployments and also the upgrade paths between them. So now that we have established what information we need to make good upgrades, basically, let's dive into the main topic, namely how can we deploy and upgrade SNSs? And there are two basic possibilities how we can do that. First, of course, everyone can choose to compile the code and install the canisters on any application subnet and then manually upgrade them to whatever they want. As an alternative, we also propose that the SNSs can be provided as a system function, which would mean that in contrast to the self-deployment, they would live on a special subnet, and they would then be automatically kept up to date. So this would not require any more input basically from the users. I will now first go into a little bit more detail of how the self-deployment would work. But then for the rest of this talk, I would mainly focus on the SNS as a system function, just for the simple reason that the self-deployment allows for, of course, unbounded number of possibilities. All right, so first, as I said, of course, everyone can just take the code in the repo, build the canisters and deploy them on an application subnet. They can choose to follow the upgrade paths in the registry. So to, if they want some confidence that what the SNS upgrades do has been well tested by others, for example, they can of course choose to do so. But the SNS community can also choose to deviate from this blessed path, or they can even choose to completely change the code of the governance or the ledger or the root. So as this is basically what provides maximum flexibility. However, this approach also comes with some disadvantages. So first, any upgrade of governance ledger or root requires some work from the SNS community. So first, someone needs to build the canister and actually make a proposal stating that it should be upgraded to this new version. And then the SNS community also needs to vote on that. And this might be challenging, especially if, for example, there is a finding that, for example, there's a bug in the governance that should be fixed. This would actually mean that the SNS community has to kind of actively monitor for such things and then react in a timely manner when these upgrades should be done. Other disadvantages are that this is just on a normal application subnet. So this means both that other canisters can run on this subnet, and also that currently application subnets don't have as many nodes as, for example, the NNS. So they are a little less secure in that regard. So, as I said, I wanted to mention that this is, of course, always possible. And this is basically what an SNS can choose to have maximum flexibility. But it does come with some disadvantages, such as a little less security, probably, and also just a larger burden on the SNS community to do the work of testing and everything themselves if they want to deviate from the blessed path. So let's now look at the other option to have an SNS as a system function. So to explain this, let me first explain the subnets that are involved in this. And I use these purple dotted lines to kind of show the subnet boundaries. So on the left, we have the NNS subnet that we already know. And on the right button, we have a normal application subnet where the dApp already lives. Now, in addition, we propose to have a new SNS subnet that exclusively runs SNSs. Now, the idea is that these SNSs that are provided as a system function would not require continuous input from to make sure that they always run the latest version, but rather that these SNSs would upgrade themselves. And to do that, these canisters, of course, need to know what to upgrade to, and this information has to be on-chain. So let's now look at how we do that. So we already saw that the deployments are blessed in the registry. So basically from this, the canisters can already learn what are the latest versions that have been blessed. However, now it's important that we saw that these blessed versions actually only contain the hashes of the wasms. So to upgrade, the canisters also have to know what wasm to freshly install, basically. And therefore, we also, if all of this should be automated, we also need to have the wasms themselves on chain. And this is why we propose a new canister that holds these SNS wasm modules. And we propose to have it on this SNS subnet. So this would then, for every new SNS canister that we propose, we would then add the new wasm to this SNS wasm module canister. And this has now probably been a lot of information, but we will go through each of the steps now, how to deploy and upgrade SNSs in this setting in more detail. I just first wanted to give you kind of an overview of which are the subnets that are involved and where is all the information that we need and that we also need to update. So let's now look at this in a bit more detail and step by step. So how would an SNS be deployed? Let's assume we have an orange user that owns this dApp on this application subnet, and this orange user now wants to deploy an SNS. To do so, the user could first get a Cycles wallet. Actually, this doesn't have to be on the same application subnet as the dApp, but it's just for simplicity for now. Then the user can state that it wants to deploy a new SNS. And to do so, it would issue a call by this Cycle wallet to this SNS wasm module canister. This call has several purposes. First, it would send along enough cycles to pay for the initial cycles of the SNS. And then it would also define the initial arguments of the SNS. So this includes, for example, the initial accounts on the ledger, the token name, the initial neurons that should exist, and so forth. The SNS wasm module canister would then check that these initial arguments are consistent. So for example, for each neuron, there's actually an account on the ledger and so forth. And it would also make some other checks. For example, that there's actually still space for new SNSs on this subnet. If all of these checks are good, it would then create these new canisters, the governance, the ledger, and root. So just maybe one detail, what would be the user experience of that? We propose in this first version to integrate this, basically the inputs that are required from the user in DFX. And then later we envision that this could actually be included kind of in a more user-friendly front end to make this open to an even wider audience. But we felt, because many developers already know DFX, that this would be a good starting point. So now that we have an SNS deployed, how can we now achieve that this SNS will continuously upgrade itself to the latest version so that the users don't have to do additional work for that? So as previously stated, the information, what should be the newest version that the SNSs should run on, is both in the registry, and the actual wasm canisters are on this new canister. So that means that if we want to add a new version, we have to update it in these two places first, and then the SNSs can pull this information and upgrade themselves. So let's first look at how we can update this information and basically bless a new deployment version. So let's, for example, assume that the blue user wants to propose that we upgrade this deployment by upgrading the ledger to version 1. So the blue user would then extensively test that and make sure that the upgrade to this new deployment actually works, that the ledger version 1 is compatible with the current governance and root. And if they did so, they would then issue a proposal to the governance canister. The NNS community would then do the same tests and make sure that they're confident that this is something that they can kind of support. And if this is the case, the proposal would be adopted and the information in the registry would be updated to say that you can upgrade to this new deployment. Now we also need to update basically the right side here. So for that, the same user or any other user can send the wasm of this ledger version 1 to the SNS wasm module canister. And it doesn't matter who does that, so any principal can make this call, because the SNS wasm module canister would then check whether this new version is one that has previously been blessed on the registry. And only if that's the case, it would actually accept this new wasm module. And if that's the case, it would then update its information. So here you can see we would now have a new SNS ledger available. So this is basically already how we can update all the information. And given this information, the SNS canisters can then upgrade themselves. And how this works is the governance canister of the SNS can just regularly check whether there are new versions in the registry. So it would know which version all the SNS canisters run and can compare the versions on the registry with that. And if there are new versions, it could then get this WASM from the SNS WASM module canister and initiate the update. Yeah, so that's already how this, the auto upgrades would work. Now, something that I haven't mentioned in all of that is how and when we actually shift the control of the dApp to the SNS. And that was a deliberate choice that we didn't want to mention that because we want to keep this as flexible as possible. So by not including that in the design for getting a new SNS, basically users can get an SNS at any point in time. And at any other point in time, they can then just change the dApps controller to the SNS. And in particular, this allows for different options. It allows developers to create an SNS and immediately change the controller of the dApp to this SNS. But it also allows developers to maybe deploy an SNS, add the SNS as the controller of the dApp, but remain also controllers themselves. And then after some time, if they have a lot enough confidence that the SNS works as they intend, they can then remove themselves from the controllers and make the dApp fully SNS controlled. And finally, this allows also to just deploy an SNS without even having a dApp, and then maybe use the SNS to get initial funding or to first find out what the community even wants, and then later only actually develop the dApp and assign its control to the SNS. This also allows, and I think this was a question on the forum, to actually add new canisters to a dApp or to a SNS, because you could then just also change this new canisters controller to the already existing SNS. Right, so that's really why we wanted to keep that a little bit independent of the process of getting an SNS. All right, now we're already on the subject of control. So let's also look at the other new canisters that we have and what are their controllers. So first we propose that this new SNS WASM module canister is controlled by the NNS root canister. And this is not something that's actually needed to update to add new WASM modules to this canister. We already saw that this can be done by an API call from anyone from the outside. Rather, this is needed if we ever want to actually change the logic of the SNS WASM modules canister. Maybe we need to fix some bugs, or we have to change these checks that this canister does when deploying an SNS. So for all of these reasons, we might want to change it later. And therefore, as it is a system canister, we propose that the root canister, who also controls all the other NNS canisters, controls this. This would mean that to change it, we actually have to send a proposal to the NNS that would then call root and initiate those upgrades. Now, within the SNS, we propose that the root canister controls all the other canisters, including the dApp canisters, and that the governance canister controls the root canister. So within this SNS, I think it would be an equally good option to have governance control all the others, and then root just have control governance. We basically didn't see a big advantage or disadvantage of either of these options, and we then went for this option because this is very similar to what we already do on the NNS. And this is just what we have already been testing for a few months now. So that's why in the end we proposed this solution. So now that we know how the deployments work, who controls what, let's maybe look a little bit more detail into this SNS subnet. So we're actually still to some extent discussing how this SNS subnet could be best realized. But I think what is kind of clear is the requirements that we would like this subnet to have. First, we want this subnet only to host SNSs for security reasons, basically that no other canister can interfere. And we also wanted to have a larger replication, so more nodes than other application subnets. And currently we're thinking about starting with 34 nodes. And because there are more nodes and more application, we also think that this subnet should be more expensive than other application subnets. Yeah, just because there is actually, we also need to kind of pay more nodes to actually run the computations. So now, given that, you might ask, well, a subnet cannot hold an unbounded number of canisters. So what do we do if this SNS subnet is full? And the answer to this question is pretty simple. We can just add new SNS subnets, as we can add new subnets in general on the internet computer. So let me very briefly just explain how this would work. So as I said, this is not new. This is what we also do to just add a new application subnet to the internet computer. Anyone can make a proposal to add a new subnet. If this proposal is adopted, the information would then be updated in the registry, and the registry would actually create such a new subnet. Now, there's one thing that we need to do in addition here, because on each such subnet, we actually need the SNS wasm modules canister. So on top of that, we need a second proposal. And this is now a very similar proposal to what we would also do to install any other new system canister. Again, this would be a proposal to the NNS to install this new canister. If this proposal is adopted, this would then be a call from the governance to the root canister, and the root canister would then be able to install this new canister on the SNS subnet. Right, so, and that's basically, once we're in that stage, a user can then make the same call to this SNS wasm module canister that we have already seen to install new SNSs. And this is basically, a nice property of the internet computer that we can always add more such things if we need them over time. So this has been a lot of information. So that's why let me just very briefly recap what I think are some of the key takeaways from this talk. So first, we proposed that SNSs are hosted on a new subnet that is specific to SNSs, so only hosts SNSs and has more replication. We proposed that SNSs are deployed via DFX and that they are then automatically upgraded. But on top of that, we also, again, want to kind of underline that, of course, one can also choose to just take the open source code and deploy the canisters or any variant of them themselves if an SNS community prefers this flexibility. Yeah, so I think those are the key things. And I'm now happy to take your questions. And I think Nico will join me.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Laura. So I think we have a little bit of a shy crowd today. I have not gotten any questions, or it could mean that your presentation was crystal clear. but, you know, since we have Laura and Nico on the call, if anyone from the community has any questions around, you know, SNS, what Laura was discussing, definitely feel free to drop in the chat. The session is meant for you guys. And if not, if everything was clear, we can also close the call. So I can give everyone like 30 seconds or so to type out any questions. Cool. I guess I have a question from my end. Oh, Saikat in the chat is saying that he needs to rewatch this and he has no questions at this point. Great. I mean, that's great news, Laura. It seems like everything was very easy.
It also mean that I was too fast, but I'm happy to also take questions in the forum. There were already questions there. So
yeah, definitely.
Discussion there. Yeah,
definitely. Cool. So question from my end, when do you think, what is the timeline for some of these, you know, updates and changes you proposed? When will that be implemented?
Right. So the as I mentioned, we already started basically the work on just the governance canister. And this is scheduled for, I think, let me think about it. No, I think this is scheduled for Q1. And then this one, kind of the deployment and upgrade of the SNS would be scheduled for Q2.
Cool. Thank you. And Emma is asking, where can she find the link to the discussion and the forum. If either Lara or Nico has it.
I don't have it here right now.
Oh, Psycott dropped it in the chat. That's so fast.
Yes, I think that's the right one. Thanks for sharing.
Okay, awesome. Okay, well, it seems like there aren't any questions from the people within the audience. So big thank you for our audience for tuning in. Thank you, Lara, for preparing the presentation. Thank you, Nico, as well, for joining in. And I will see you guys at a future community conversation. Bye, everyone.
Thank you very much. Bye.